this evening, we're just going to flow. Like the rain falling down onto the earth, into the creek, into the river, into the ocean. Flowing up, falling down. Once there was nothing. Nothing but the spirit of all life. For a long time, there was nothing. Then in the mind of the spirit of life, a dreaming began. In the empty darkness, there was a dreaming of fire.
Bunjo did not understand the dream.
and wanted to dream only of the wind and the open sky. So Bunjil passed the secret of dreaming onto the spirit of the Kunurang, the spirit of the possum. And Kunurang climbed high into the tree, looked at the night sky, and began to dream. Kunurang dreamed of wide plains and yellow grass, but Kunurang did not understand the dream, and only wanted to dream of the trees and the night sky. So Kunurang passed the secret of dreaming onto the kangaroo. And kangaroo stood tall, looked across the plain at the yellow grass, and began to dream. Kangaroo dreamed of music and song and laughter, but kangaroo did not understand the dream and wanted to dream only of the wide plains and yellow grass. So kangaroo passed the secret of dreaming onto the spirit of man. And man walked across the land and saw all the works of creation. He heard the bird song at dawn and saw the red sun at dusk and began to dream. Man dreamed of sharing the music of dawn birds, the dance of the emu, and the red ochre of sunset. And he dreamed also of the laughter of children. And man understood the dream. So he continued to dream of all the things that he dreamed before. He dreamed of the deep still water, of the waves and wet sand, the rocks and warm sun, the wind and open sky, the trees and the night sky, and the plains of the yellow grass. And man knew through the dreaming that all creatures were his spirit cousins, and that he must protect their dreaming. And he dreamed of how he would tell these secrets to his child who was not yet born. Then Great Spirit knew at last that the secret of dreaming was safe and being tied from the dreaming of creation. The spirit of life entered the land to rest. So that now, when the spirits of all creatures become tired, they join the spirit of life in the land. So this is why the land is sacred. And man must be its caretaker.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Mother Earth. Is that really you? My mother from days of old, the victim of such degradation from methods so crude and bold. Like a vulture to a carcass, your resources, they just devour, providing a sense of social importance and egotistical power. They care not for your mum, care not for your health. You just offer short-term solutions, all in the name of wealth. See, I've listened on many still nights. I can hear you bellowing and screaming, wishing your guardians would return to the nurturing ways of the dreaming. The pain must have been so excruciating, Mother, as you were ripped and torn apart. To ensure a successful recovery, we'll have to start doing one thing for a start. Follow the ways of your ancestors. Never take more than you need. Just as long as you have a roof over your head and in your stomach a nourishing feed. But the battle still rages today, and no excuse will suffice. If we're going to attain preservation, just live by the following advice. Why don't we just quit all this fighting? Abolish all of this fuss. Here, we can never own this priceless land. Mother Earth really owns us.
Thank you.
but I believe he's 80 years old, looking about 5 years younger than me. And the good thing is, ladies, he's single.
I'm not. Oh. Thank you.
Just imagine now that you're barefoot on country, breathing in the air and walking with the spirit of the land. As you breathe in, the breath of the trees greets your breath. And slowly, 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 the ancestors begin to emerge from the landscape. They emerge from the trees, from the waters, from the air, from the fire. They emerge from the earth. And these ancestors walk up to you and greet you. They look deep into your eyes. And as they greet you, they greet the ancestors within you. Ancestor to ancestor. History to history. These ancestors walk you around on their country. They show you places that are for women and places that are for men and places where all gather together, men, women, and children. These ancestors point out the sacred places where we should not go. Slowly, slowly, they walk you, let you taste the waters, breathe in the air, and share your breath with country. Feeling barefoot, flat on the earth, you walk in the footsteps of those who have gone before you, knowing that you are not the first, and knowing that there will be others who follow in your footsteps in turn. Slowly the ancestors go back into the landscape now, and as you walk on country, you know that they are with you and watching. We'd like to say thank you to Hal over there on the chimes. Gomeroi is running a Yiraki, a didgeridoo workshop for anybody that's interested. Chase him up afterwards and let us know so we can give you the address of where to go. But other than that, I hope you enjoyed the journey.
Everyone say Yahoo. Can you say that? Yahoo. Turn to each other and say, "Ooh, baloo."